Let's talk about how to compare fractions. So obviously, if we have 1/5 and 2/5, that's easy to compare because the bottoms match up. And what we're saying here is we have 1/5 or one part out of 5. Imagine a pizza sliced into 5 slices. You've eaten one of them. Whereas here, you've eaten 2 of those slices. So that's obviously bigger. It gets a little bit more confusing for people when the bottom numbers don't match up. But it really doesn't have to be confusing. Let's say you have 2/5 and 3/7, and you want to compare them. It's a little bit hard to imagine which is bigger. In fact, they're both slightly less than half. 2 is a little less than half of 5, 3 is a little less than half of 7, so it'd be a little bit hard to know which is bigger. But all we do is make the bottoms equal. We look for a common denominator. So the common denominator here is going to be 35, and if ever you're stuck, you just multiply 5 and 7, the two numbers, and that'll give you the common denominator. You know, you want to look for the lowest common denominator, but if ever you're stuck, you can always just take that one and then reduce. So we're going to get the bottoms to be 35 in both cases. So 5 times 7 is 35. That means I have to multiply the top by 7 as well. 2 times 7 is 14. Here, I wanted to get 35, so I have to multiply 7 by 5 to get 35. So I have to multiply the top by 5 as well. I'm going to write it here. And this one was by 7. So I'm going to multiply 5 by 7 to get the 35. So I'll multiply 5 on top as well. 5 times 3 is 15. So now when I compare the two fractions, this is 14 out of 35, and this is 15 out of 35. So that one is bigger. That one is larger. If you had a pizza divided into 35 slices, here you've eaten 14, here you've eaten 15, and that's the bigger one.